Good afternoon. I know it's going to be a difficult session right after the lunch. Okay, so in order to stay successful for over a period of time, you need to continuously look into the technology and vision. Both need to be changed so that you can stay successful. One thing about a technology is not something in your control, which is driven by the external factors. On the contrary, the vision is something internal, which is the primary responsibility of CEO to set the direction or vision for the organization. It's not only setting the vision or direction, which is something you need to look into a regular interval and see whether you are progressing in the right direction, or after achieving the particular the goal, we need to reset the vision. If you look at the companies, even the global companies like Google or Microsoft, the vision what they taken in the beginning of the initial phase of the organization, the journey, and what is today, it's completely different. Look at what are the goal of a vision of the Microsoft. A personal computer at every home. Today, Microsoft is much bigger than they're able to achieve that, you know. Today, people have multiple PCs. And today, into many businesses, not only that, you know, initially what they've taken and want to have the PC at every home. Look at even the Google vision. Initially, it is about organizing the world's information in a meaningful way so that people can access it. Today, the Google looking at many things. You're talking about autonomous car, and talking about increasing lifespan of the people, because they are able to achieve that, you know, organizing the world's the information in a meaningful way. So it is that the vision is something that we need to look into at a regular interval and see whether, look, the company is able to achieve it and reset the vision. Because the company is not growing means you need to look into vision, whether see whether we set the right vision. It's not about the direction. It's about the driving is what matters. The what are the journey what you have taken, it's important that we need to drive toward the direction. In case you are not able to achieve it or able to achieve it, we need to once again reset the direction, which is the vision. Talking about the technologies, there are a lot of changes happening in the technology thing. And again, technology today, it's progressing at a much faster pace than ever before. 15 years ago, if someone had told you that in India we'll have close to 1 billion phone connection, everyone was surprised. Today it progresses much rapid pace. It's not only about many things. Today, every decade, the technology evolutions happening at a much faster pace. So coping up with those challenges is difficult for any organization. So one thing about technology challenges is about the speed in which is the changes are happening. And second thing about, there are too many options. Which option to choose? If you as an entrepreneur, you look at the database, you have multiple database options. You look at a operating system, you have many options. Then you have open source, you have a paid service, then you go for a paid one, there are annual AMCs. The choosing the right software is one of the challenge. In fact, if you don't choose a right technology partner, a right technology, no matter of how big you are, we cannot guarantee the success. Who would have thought the Nokia, probably less than a decade ago, they had a 90% market share on a mobile phone. They are number one brand when it comes to the economic survey. Consistently, they are rated as the number one brand. And they had a large distribution channel in India. They had a phone for every customer. They had the various. And the one thing they failed to see was the evolution of the smartphone. Not only that, they failed to see the evolution of smartphones. Also, while they seen that the smartphone was evolving, they didn't choose the right technology partner in my view. If at all, the Nokia had chosen in my view, instead of the Microsoft, or instead of relying on their own operating system, I think Symbian or something, they could have seen that, look, Android going to come. If they had adopted Android as operating system, I'm sure Nokia would add some markets in India. Wouldn't be the kind of disaster what they had in terms of, instead of having that such a large distribution and having so many options. So it's not about, again, technology. So instead of being a number one, they fail to see the technology evolution that taken place, which they failed to adapt, and the result was disastrous. And the other challenge about technology is that it's about changing the parts of the machine while it's running. Because company like, particularly company like us, internet companies, because we want to move from one technology to other technology, so obviously we have to ensure that the services are working 24/7, but you need to make those changes. So it's about the changing the parts of the moving car or working machines. That's the biggest challenge. And how do you choose is the right technology? So that's the other thing, because so many technologies available. Am I betting on the right technology? Because the changes are going to be very costly. Today, the company, we have 3 million active users. There are millions of the visitors on a monthly basis. We have used a lot of open softwares, and again, new things are evolving. We have a Spings for certain things, whereas you want to, whether you want to move to Elasticsearch. Again, choosing whether are you investing big end or betting on the right technology. Because if you don't choose the right technology, the result can be, again, as I said, it can be disastrous, because it's happened even for the global company, as I talked about Nokia. There's a company called Friendster. I don't know how many of you know. This was the first social network site to become popular, actually. What the Friendster failed to do was, when the growth was happening, they did not invest sufficiently behind their infrastructure. When the traffic was scaling up, since they did not scale up the infrastructure, the social network sites emerged like other things. Well, eventually Facebook became successful. So the technology, we have all those challenges. So it's about, as an entrepreneur, or you should ensure that you have to invest behind the right technologies and invest behind the right partner, because if you choose the wrong partner, again, the result can be challenging. So how do you ensure that you are able to deal with this technology changes or challenges? This is what we do in our company. First and foremost, you have to ensure that keep an eye on the evolving technologies. Because in order to stay relevant, you need to adopt these changing technologies and have a strong R&D team. Because the R&D team can continuously look into the evolving technologies, and they can give the right advice. Also look into what the global leaders are doing it, the people whom you benchmark, the global leaders. Because many of these companies, they talk about what are the software they are using. And there are a lot of open forums, and you can look at a peer network, and you can access to those people. So again, just talking about how to cope up with the technology challenges. So peer networking, so these are the various ways we can look into, you know, the technology changes, and we can choose the right technologies. Talking about a matrimony, that's a point I want to come to. So when I started this matrimony venture, it was a one-page site, one page for brides, one page for groom. Thankfully, I come from technology background. So initially, the only software I was comfortable with was the C language. It was the flat file. That's why I started the bharatmatrimony.com, then migrated to MySQL, and today, while it was initially desktop, today the mobile is the largest source of acquiring profiles for us. Today, more than 75% of profile acquisition for us happening through the mobile thing. Today, the bharatmatrimony.com is not a single website. I don't know how many of you know. It's a group called matrimony.com. Well, bharatmatrimony having 15 sites, we have another offering called communitymatrimony.com. 300 plus sites are part of communitymatrimony.com. For us, managing almost like 350 sites close to that is a challenge. And not only that, we have to take care of the customers, the desktop and the mobile app. You're talking about Android, iOS, and there are multiple versions. Today, InnoSet began the technology team. We have a strong technology team. We are able to manage it so effectively. The one thing about, as I said, as a company, wouldn't be what you are today if you are not adapted with the changing technology thing happen. Because the mobile something really caught up as a surprise. We didn't even expect we'd be having so much of the profile acquisition currently witnessing, you know, happening through what's happening through mobile. It was not the case few years ago. So that's something, you know, this is the biggest challenge for entrepreneurs. The changing technologies, adapting so that you can stay relevant.